Good evening. So firstly, thank you for being here on this really, I would say, balmy, cold. It's kind of warm. That's kind of nice. So we're going to have an amazing evening this evening. I think from the Chopra Foundation, I'm Punacha Machaya. I want to thank you all for coming this evening. And it's my extreme honor to invite the co-founder of the mental health movement, Gabriella Wright, to come on stage first. She is the force behind Never Alone Mental Health, and it's my extreme pleasure to have the founder, chairman of the Chopra Foundation, the visionary behind well-being, Dr. Deepak Chopra. So before we get started, I just want to say a quick word of thanks to Saul Searle, who is the president of the Howard Hughes business, and also Andrew Schwartz, and also Frank, who's really been instrumental in really having this evening set up. And what I wanted to do was to really kind of share a few, in a few words, why we are here. As the Chopra Foundation, Deepak's mission is for a more peaceful, just, sustainable, healthier, and joyful world. That is what we want to do at the Chopra Foundation. And everything we do every day is to create community, what we call Sangha. So we're really grateful that post-COVID, we can actually finally get together and create more communities of like-minded people. The second thing I want to share with you all today is a little bit of what I would call a reflection moment. Every 40 seconds, we lose someone to suicide globally. This is the tragedy of our times. And this, yet, October 10th was Mental Health Awareness Month. So this month, we are really dedicating the work we do in the foundation to really create communities across the US and also globally. And I want to share two programs which I'm really proud about. One is Never Alone, which Deepak and Gabriella will talk about, which is really focused on mental health and suicide prevention and well-being. And in mental health, over the pandemic, we used technology to really look at mental health. We deployed an AI chatbot called PV. In over a one-year period, we had more than 24 million text messages exchanged on it, over 4 million minutes of conversation, and 4,900 suicide interventions. So what really we want is that people to really start communicating, leveraging technology. The other thing which we are focused on right now is really looking at psychedelic medicine. We are doing a lot of frontier research in ketamine-assisted psychotherapy. We're working with leading researchers in psilocybin, and we find a lot of promise in the area of psychedelic medicine. And the third area is longevity. So once again, please do support the foundation, the ChopraFoundation.org. We'd love to hear from you. Also, love for you to participate with us. So with that, thank you for joining us, and hand it over to Deepak and Gabriella. Thank you.
Thank you, Punacha. Good evening, everyone. Thank you for being and creating this wonderful space where we will share a Never Alone conversation, just setting the tone of what we do and how we can help you, the community, how we can help ourselves and enhance leadership for mental well-being. I am the co-founder of Never Alone, which is the mental health and suicide prevention initiative of the Chopra Foundation. And this started from a very personal journey. My little sister died by suicide 4 years ago. And it was a blind spot, you know? It was a blind spot because we always think it happens to other people. And then when it happens, you actually don't know what to do. And you feel helpless and almost homeless in the sense that you've lost a sense of being with yourself because you don't know what that is anymore. So grief, suicide, it's collective trauma. We're all going through it right now. It might be more personal to others than some, but we all know someone who's experienced either depression, existential depression, mental health illness, mental distress. So that's what we're going to start today, and we will end this lovely conversation with a meditation from Freedom from Suffering, The Path to Joy with Dr. Deepak Chopra. Deepak, I'm going to ask a very simple question. Why are we experiencing so much mental distress today? I mean, 1 in 10 Americans are experiencing depression. Every 40 seconds, like Punacha mentioned, someone dies by suicide. So what is it in the world? Why are we here at this state of time in this collective depression?
So thanks, Gabriella. And You could hear Gabriella clearly over there, everyone? So you can hear me clearly?
Yes.
Okay, good. So depression is a result, other than there are a few psychoses, and we'll talk about that too, other than a few psychoses that are genetically determined to some extent, not all, depression is the depletion of energy that comes from the memory of trauma. And every human being has been traumatized at some point. Whether it was in childhood, they were traumatized sexually or verbally or emotionally. They were told, you're not good enough or you'll never be good enough. And that memory of trauma is there in all of us. And if you don't think you have the memory of trauma, you've just blocked it. You've just blocked it. Trauma includes trauma in childhood, trauma in adolescence, trauma in adults, trauma in the womb, and trauma, intergenerational trauma from our ancestors. This we know now for sure.
Yes.
So every single human being is prone to depression, ultimately. What is depression? There's a wide range. So one end is simple, minor, occasional sadness. But then you have deep depression, and on the other, and you have the psychoses, and on the other hand, you have the worst thing that can happen to a human being. They don't want to live anymore. They die from suicide. The memory of trauma is anger. The memory of trauma is anger. So when somebody says something to you and you get really upset, it's not because of what they said. What they said precipitated the anger that was already there as a result of trauma. The desire to get even is called hostility, and hostility is a very dangerous emotion. It's actually the number one psychological reason for premature death from heart disease, hostility. The anticipation of trauma in the future is fear, anxiety. The direction of that to yourself is guilt. And if you have guilt, then you have shame and humiliation. And all of that combined depletes energy, which we call depression. So of course, in between this, we have the major psychoses, which are part of intergenerational trauma, but also genetic predisposition. And so, you know, as at Never Alone, we believe we have to help everyone. It doesn't matter what the means might be. Psychedelics for certain people, AI, deep learning, artificial intelligence, emotional chatbots for others, pharmaceuticals for some, not all, and then the new era that we're exploring right now, digiceuticals. We can talk about that too. So this is what depression is. And that's why it's common, because right now what's happening is, because of social media, everybody has lost their sense of self. And everybody, I like to say this kind of as a joke, we have sacrificed ourselves for our selfies. And what happens is, when your identity is not yourself, it's your selfie, then you're looking for how many likes, who's criticizing me. You've lost your identity. And that loss of identity creates separation. We feel divided. We feel separate. I'm here and the rest of the world is out there. When in the deeper reality, we're all expressions of one consciousness. And when we understand that, then there is only love. There's only compassion. There's only empathy. And there's only joy.
I love that, we're going on the road to find ourselves. And I think that's probably something that we don't really generally hear when we speak about mental health. It's actually a journey. Now, it's a journey towards the self. It's a journey so that there is no separation between yourself and the world, thus the movement, Never Alone. Deepak, I think there would be a wonderful distinction, and you just mentioned it. And I think maybe you would like to hear this, because we talk about sadness, we talk about emotions, we talked about all of this. But what is the difference between happiness and joy?
Very important question, because we have to first create happiness, but ultimately the journey is joy. Happiness is for a reason, always. Okay, so you say, I'm happy because I fell in love. I'm happy because I have lots of money. I'm happy because I have good health.
I'm happy because I passed my exams.
Passed my exams.
Exactly.
So happiness is a mental experience, which is the opposite of sadness. In fact, you only know happiness because you've experienced sadness. All experiences by contrast, up and down, happy, sad, young, old, hot, cold, cold right now, but we recognize the cold because we experience hot. So otherwise, we wouldn't know what cold is. All experience is by contrast. Your body, your physical body, is a projection of your stories of happiness and sadness. So if I asked you to close your eyes, we'll do a meditation later, and do nothing, you'll start recognizing that you're telling yourself a story. And the story is of the past. And there are two kinds of stories you're telling that, yourself. Stories of good experiences. The body feels happy. Stories of bad experiences. The body feels unhappy. And in Eastern wisdom traditions, the physical body is called a conceptual body or a karmic body. Karma means stories. And so happiness, there's a reason, and we can talk about what the reasons are for happiness, happiness equation formula.
Absolutely.
But joy has nothing to do with that. Joy is independent of both happiness and sadness. It is what a child is before they have been programmed by the social mind into what we call the divided, separate self. So, you know, before the programming occurs, when language happens, just watch a child. And the child is naturally happy, unless it's wet or it's hungry, and the mother takes care of that. But a child is joyful for no reason. Joy has no reason. It's our fundamental state. Joy is associated with curiosity, with wonder, with empathy, with compassion, and with what we say ultimately equanimity. Equanimity means the peace that passes understanding. And a baby is like that, by the way. You know, if you hurt somebody in front of a baby, your dog or your cat, your KK, the baby will wince because they feel what the traumatized person is feeling, or even an animal is feeling. Babies have natural empathy. They viscerally feel the trauma of others. Babies naturally have compassion, which means the desire to alleviate suffering. And babies are naturally loving. You should see babies that are trying to catch your eye all the time. And as soon as you catch their eye, they smile, they beam. Okay, so what is joy? Joy is a return to our original state of innocence before we got programmed into the divided social mind.
The path to joy.
The path to joy.
The path to joy. So ultimately what we're talking about here is that how do we move our separate self into a state of communion with everything, like the beaming baby that's fluctuating and changing the frequency of a room. We all notice that. We walk into a room, oh God, I don't feel happy here. Ugh. But how can you change that moment? Because ultimately the change is within you. It's not the exterior circumstances. So ultimately, Deepak, because we have the power of igniting this, how do we really do it? And how do we come from this pandemic of mental health to a pandemic of joy ultimately? How do we do this? Because this is why we're here. This is a community meditation community conversation. We want you to have the tools. We want the tools. I need the tools.
Well, we created four tools at Never Alone. And please check out neveralone.love and get involved, whatever way you want to get involved. And the tools we are using at Never Alone are three. One is a spiritual practice, like meditation, but other spiritual practices, like reflection, transcendence. That spiritual practice in Eastern wisdom traditions is called sadhana, the practice every day. The second is community. This is a community, but this is a live community. This could be an online community. In fact, it will be. We are filming this so we can encourage other people to create their own online communities. So that's called Sangha. The first one was
meditation
is sadhana. And the third one is actually remembering who we are. We are not our selfies. We are a pure being that is existence, awareness, and joy. The Sanskrit word for this is Sat Chit Ananda. It's actually used as a mantra. Sat means truth. Truth is what? We exist. Chit means awareness. And Ananda means joy. And so what we decided in our programming at Never Alone is to focus on four things that a mother does when she looks at her baby, okay? So what does, you know, baby do? Well, before they have language, hi, there's one little wonderful being here, right in the front. So when a baby looks at its mother and it doesn't yet know how to speak, all it looks at its mother's eyes. Is she happy? Is she unhappy? Listens to the tone of her voice. Is she anxious or is she loving? Facial expressions, same thing. Is she angry, frustrated? We have 43 facial muscles and 150 facial expressions. A baby can read them without language. So tone of voice, facial expressions, eye movements, body language, and gestures. Is she contracted? Is she open? So what is the baby looking for? Four things. Attention, which means deep listening. Is she listening? Appreciation. Does she notice how unique I am? Is she grateful? I mean, baby doesn't have these words, but that's what it's looking for. Attention, deep listening, appreciation, deep gratitude. Affection, deep love, and acceptance. You are good enough and more than good enough just as you are, because nobody is perfect. In fact, if you are perfect, then there's something wrong with you. Okay, we all have these so-called positive and negative traits. So those are the four A's: attention, affection, appreciation, and acceptance. And I mentioned digiceuticals to you. So here's a digiceutical. You can create your own, but we're also creating. So for each of these words, attention, appreciation, acceptance, and affection, you create a little emoticon with a kiss and a hug and this and that. Add some music to it. Send it to two people. And you'll give them a dopamine hit. You'll give them a serotonin hit. You'll give them an oxytocin hit. That's a digiceutical. You know, all you've done is send a person a kiss, a smile, and a hug, and say, I'm thinking of you. And send it to two people. Have them send their version to two more people, and so on. And if we reach a critical mass of that kind of thinking, attention, affection, appreciation, acceptance, I think we can create a pandemic of joy. And that's what we should be here. Not just treating mental distress, but actually creating a critical mass of people in the world, starting with our teens and younger children, because our humanity is incomplete. If our children are committing or dying of suicide, and it's become the second most common cause of death, shame on us. They are our children.
Absolutely.
So our humanity is incomplete. We have to take care of our children and their children. And the only way we can do it is, in fact, we create this pandemic of joy.
And I think what's beautiful about that is that all of a sudden we're realizing that we all matter. We all matter here. We all have this social responsibility. And it's not like, oh, I'm wearing a t-shirt and this is what I need to do. No, it's just being who you are, reconnecting with the source of who you are. And that can just, you know, bring, oh yeah, he's wearing a t-shirt and it's joy. That was not staged, by the way, at all. But the point being is you become the t-shirt. You're wearing your joy, you're becoming joy, and that is the path to self. That is the journey towards yourself, and it's the greatest adventure that you could ever have, because you're discovering who you are, and you're going through these cycles of emotional excellence, of the Himalayas, the valleys of your own self, the dark night of the soul, and all of that is okay because you are the ocean and you are everything. You are the universe.
And we can hang around each other through those four A's: attention, appreciation, acceptance, and affection.
And so having said that, Deepak, I think it would be a lovely moment to start the meditation to take us on our journey.
So I'll do that.
Yes, thank you.
Thank you. Thanks, Gabriela. Okay, so please be as comfortable as you can be. Don't have to sit in lotus or some fancy yogic asana. The most important thing is to be comfortable. And let's close our eyes and we'll start with observing our breath. Just observe your breath. This was the first mindfulness practice of the Buddha. The Buddha means the enlightened one. And when he noticed his breath, he came to the conclusion that we don't breathe, we are being breathed. The air is our breath. And every breath is a sensation. It arises, we experience it, and then it leaves. And the Buddha said, every experience is a sensation. It arises, we experience it, and then it leaves. If you hold on to your breath, you will suffocate. And from this comes the famous expression, let go and flow. Let go and flow. So now, just relax, let go and flow. Now bring your awareness to your heart mentally, and mentally ask yourself, who am I? Who am I? Don't try to answer the question. Just ask the question. If an answer comes to you in the form of a sensation, a feeling, an image, or a thought, then notice it, but let it go, okay? Who am I? Who am I? And now, mentally ask yourself the question, what do I want? Once again, don't try to answer it. Just ask the question. What do I want? Allowing any sensation, any image, any feeling, any thought to come to you. And when it does, notice it and let it go. What do I want? What do I want? And now move to the third question. What is my purpose? What is my calling? Once again, allowing any sensation, any image, any feeling, any thought to come to you. What is my purpose? And now the final question, what am I grateful for? When you ask this question, you open the door to your soul. You open the door to abundance, infinite abundance, generosity of spirit. What am I grateful for? What am I grateful for? Okay, now that we're done with inquiry, let us go a little bit in the direction of mindfulness. So once again, become aware of your breath. And as you become aware of your breath, just mentally say to yourself, I am present in every breath I take. I am present in every breath I take. And now turn your attention to sound, including the sound of my voice. So many sounds here now. You can see some drones in the background, traffic, sometimes ambulance. Just like the breath, sound is a sensation. It arises, we experience it, and then it leaves. So now, bring your awareness to any sound that you're hearing. Sound of the airplane, the helicopter, my voice, whatever. Focus on sound and remind yourself, I am present in every sound I hear. I am, well, we are being obliged. I am present in every sound I hear. Now take one of your hands and rub it against the other hand gently, or even touch your clothes, and mentally remind yourself, I am present in everything I touch. I am present in everything I touch. And now just for a few moments, open your eyes. Look around this beautiful skyscape. Look at these buildings, look at the sky. Look at all these colors, these shapes, these forms. And remind yourself, I am present in everything I see. Now close your eyes again. Generate some saliva in your mouth. Taste the saliva. Taste the roof of your mouth, the back of your teeth. And remind yourself, I am present in everything I taste. I am present. Once again, take your hand and bring it to your nostrils and inhale whatever smell comes to you from your hands and just remind yourself, I am present in everything I smell. I am present in everything I smell. Now let's go a little deeper, okay? So let's generate some images in our awareness. Let's practice some imagination. So imagine a beautiful sunset on the ocean. Imagine snow-clad mountains. Imagine a starlit sky. Imagine the full moon. Imagine beautiful New York City, the Empire State Building, the Statue of Liberty. And remind yourself, I am present in everything I imagine. I am present in everything I imagine. Let's go a little deeper and generate some emotion. And let's choose the highest emotion, which is love. So think of someone that you deeply love. It could be your child, your grandchild, your significant other, anyone that you love, and bring their awareness into your heart, and then feel the emotion in your heart, the emotion, the highest emotion, love, as ultimate truth. And as you do that, remind yourself, I am present in every emotion I generate, because we generate our emotions. I am present in every emotion I generate. Now, keeping your eyes closed, ask yourself, I wonder what my next thought is going to be. I wonder what my next thought is going to be. And then wait for a thought to come. Allow it to come across the screen of your consciousness. Observe the thought. And remind yourself, I am present in every thought that floats across the screen of my consciousness. I am present in every thought. Thoughts are like clouds in the sky. We are not the clouds, we are the sky. We are the presence. I am present in every thought that comes to me. And now let your awareness move outside the boundaries of your skin and let your awareness pervade all of space and time. Let your awareness move from your skin to New York City, to the entire country, to the planet, to the solar system, and beyond. And remind yourself, I am present in every experience that can happen across the fabric of space and time. I am present in every experience across the fabric of space and time. Now let all of that go and just mentally repeat your name to yourself. I'm Deepak, I'm Mary, I'm John. Even as you repeat your name, remind yourself that that's your name, it's not who you are. So now drop your name. Instead of saying, I'm John, I'm Mary, I'm Deepak, just say, I am, with no name and no form attached to it. No memory, no story. Just I am, I am, I am. And now, if you want, replace the I am with the vibration, with the mantra. And the mantra is aham. I exist. I am aware. Aham. 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 Okay, now keep doing this. If you get distracted, just come back to the mantra, aham. And please don't mind the time. I will track the time for you. It'll be a couple of minutes, okay? So keep repeating the mantra. Aham, aham, aham. Mentally, without moving your lips or your tongue. Aham. 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 And now let the mantra go. Let the mantra go and rest in your own presence. Rest in your own presence. Be aware of being aware. This is who we are, presence. We are not our name, we are not our body, we are not our mind. We are the presence in which we experience our body, our mind, and the world. So, just be aware of your own presence. Rest in it. Presence has no shape, no age. It doesn't exist in time. It is our soul. Presence is our soul. So rest in your presence. before we come out, feel your body now. Feel your body, feel the sensations in your body. As you feel the sensations in your body, plant your body with the following intention. Just repeat it mentally as you feel your body. Joyful, energetic body. Repeat that phrase as you feel your body. Joyful, energetic body. And now bring your awareness to your heart. And mentally, speak to your heart. Loving, compassionate heart. Loving, compassionate heart. Now bring your awareness to your third eye between your eyebrows with the following intention: reflective, quiet, creative mind. Reflective, quiet, creative mind. And finally, once again, let your awareness go beyond the boundaries of your skin. Let it spread out everywhere in all directions with the intention, lightness of being, lightness of spirit, lightness of being, lightness of spirit. Finally, relax into your body. Take a minute or so, and please open your eyes. So, in conclusion, what we call our soul, our spirit, is our presence. It's not what we think, not what we say, but our being, presence. So right now, as you're listening to me, as you're listening to the sound, as you're looking at me, turn your attention right now to that which is listening, to that which is looking. Be aware, even as you look at me, of that which is looking. Even as you listen to me, to that which is listening. Be aware of that right now. That presence is your soul. It was there when you were a baby, different body, different mind, but that presence was there. It was a different body when you were a teenager, different mind, but that presence was there. That presence never leaves. We only overlook it. So starting today, carry your presence wherever you go. And have those four intentions: joyful, energetic body, loving, compassionate heart, reflective, quiet, creative mind, and lightness of being, lighter than this breeze, lighter than this wind, lighter than space. And spread that joy wherever you go. Please check out neveralone.love and become a part of the community. Create your own community. And if you feel so inclined, a little donation to our emotional chatbot, PV, named after Gabriella's sister who died from suicide. She was called PV, but we also use PV as an acronym now for personalized interaction with intention. PV stands for personalized interaction with intention, so we can together, consciously, with intention, create this pandemic of joy. Thank you and good night. By the way, this is being filmed. It will be on live stream. You will see it on the Chopra Foundation website, choprafoundation.org, choprafoundation.org. If you want to share it with other people, tell them you were here. Okay, and they can also be part of it.